I welcome you all. Today we are going to see the very important topic, that is sleep. Good sleep is the indication of your health. If you are not sleeping well, it means your health is not okay. In this video, in addition to sleep, we are going to see certain questions. For example, what is the difference between the sleeping pattern of a child and an adult? Which side you have to sleep, either right side or left side? In case your sleep is deprived for some reasons, can you compensate that by sleeping in the next day? The next question is, why can't we run fast in dreams than others? Whether a blind person who is blind from his childhood, can he get dreams? At last, whether the animals also dream like a human being? Before seeing the answers of all these questions, if you are not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe and click the bell button. Then only you don't miss any of our videos. Normally, we think that a person goes for sleep by 10 o'clock and gets up at 6 o'clock. What he thinks that he is sleeping from 10 to 6. It is not so. In a sleep, a person undergoes various stages of sleep. The stages are broadly categorized into two. That is based on the eyeball movement. That is non-random eye movement. The another one is random eye movement. Non-random eye movement means while you are sleeping, your eyeball will not move. Whereas in case of random eye movement, your eyeball will be keep moving. Based on this criteria, the sleep is divided into two groups. First, we will see the non-random eye movement sleep. Under this, there are three stages: stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. But before the stage 1, there is one preliminary stage is there. For example, if a person is going to sleep at 10 o'clock, first 5 to 10 minutes, his body will be ready for sleep. In that stage, his brain will be relaxed. Also, in this stage, he will be getting hallucinations. For example, suddenly he may feel that he is falling from some building or something. Why this type of feeling is coming? What scientists say is that in the olden days, our ancestors were sleeping on the branches of tree. Night time, they can't sleep on the floor because of wild animals. So they'll be sleeping on the branches of tree. Since they are sleeping on the branches of tree, they cannot sleep peacefully. They'll be getting up frequently in the night. That is recorded in our genes. That genes been carried till today. That's why we are getting the dreams. Sometimes you may have the feeling that somebody is calling you by your name. Suddenly you will get up and see nobody will be there in the nearby. This is also one type of hallucination. Third one, when you are sleeping, suddenly your body will get some jerks. So these are the various hallucinations takes place first 5 to 10 minutes. That is our beginning of the sleeping stage. Once you cross this 5 to 10 minutes, then you are going to the stage 1. In the stage 1, your wakefulness and the sleep both are equal. Though you are sleeping, you will not feel that you are sleeping. If somebody comes and wakes you up and asks you what you are doing, you will say that I am just lying down. I am not yet slept. Whereas truly you are sleeping. In the stage 1, brain produces high amplitude slow waves. After 5 to 10 minutes in the stage 1, then you are entering to the stage 2. In stage 2, your awareness about the environment will come down. Your body temperature also comes down. Your heartbeat rate, that's also slows down. Normally, a person sleeps at 10 o'clock. By 10:20, he will reach this stage 2. 50% of our total sleep, we are in the stage 2. For example, if you sleep 8 hours in a night, 4 hours you will be in the stage 2. The next one is stage 3. That is very, very important stage. This is the deep sleep stage. Why it is very important? Whatever the damages happened in the tissues, muscles, bones, all are repaired in this period only. Your regrowth of tissues, muscles also takes place. Your body immunity will be increasing in this stage only. Your BP will be down. Your breathing rate, that's also will be slowing down. Persons having the habit of sleepwalking or bedwetting, all these actions are taking place in this stage only. Normally, after 90 minutes, that is 1.5 hour of our sleep, we get into the deep sleep stage. Our main purpose of sleep is to get into deep sleep. The stage 1, 2, 3, these all three stages comes under non-random eye movements. In this stage, your eyeball will not be moving. Then comes the fourth stage, that is random eye movement. In random eye movement, only one stage is there, that is stage 4. Our 20% of total sleep will be in the random eye movement stage. In this stage, our brain will be very, very active, as if you are awake. But your body is completely in rest. Though we used to get dreams in all the 1, 2, 3 stages, we won't remember those dreams. We remember the dreams only that comes in stage 4. So these are the various stages in sleep. Now you should not think that a person goes for sleep, he gets 1, 2, 3, 4, then he gets up in the morning. It's not so. A person goes to sleep, he may get 1, 2, again that will come to 1, or sometime it may go to 3, again it may come to 2, then from 3 to 4, like that it will keep moving from 4th and back. Once you touch all the stages, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4, then it is called sleep cycle, one sleep cycle. One sleep cycle is approximately 90 to 120 minutes. So if you sleep 8 hours in night, you will get 4 to 5 sleep cycles. Normally when you get up in between the night or in the morning, you will be getting up from the stage 4 only. Stage 3 is very, very important. Stage 4 is also very, very important for our mental health. So both 3 and 4 are very important. Now we will come to the questions. What is the difference between sleeping pattern of a child and an adult? A child that is below 3 years, its 50% of sleep is in random eye movement, that is stage 4 only. Why? Because it needs feeding frequently. So that's why the nature makes the child to sleep only in the stage 4. As you know, that stage 4, that is random eye movement. So when a child sleeps, if you watch, its eyeball will be keep moving. Also, since the stage 4 gives dreams, most of the time the child used to smile or weep. Whereas in case of adult, only 20% of the stage 4 sleep will be having. Remaining, he will be either in 3, 2 or 1. The second question is, which side you want to sleep, either right side or left side? What doctor advises? You sleep on the right side. Why? Because we have liver here, that is slightly bigger in size. Left side we have heart. If you sleep on left side, your liver may give some pressure on heart, which is not good for health. On the other hand, if you sleep on right side, your liver will be bottom, your heart will be at top. So it won't be a problem for us. The third question is whether a sleep deprivedness can be compensated by sleeping in the next day or the following day. The answer is no, you can't compensate. Once you lost the sleep, whatever the damages happen to your body, that will not be compensated by any means, even if you sleep completely in the following day. So sleep is very, very important. The fourth question is, why can't we run fast in dreams? As I told you, we get dreams only in the stage 4. In the stage 4, our brain will be very active, whereas our body is in complete rest state. If you get some dreams, suppose a dog is chasing you or some tiger is chasing you, or you are participating in some sports activities, everybody will be running very faster than you, because your mind will be giving commands that you run faster or do some activity faster. Since your body and muscles are entirely in rest state, so even if you try to run fast, you will be going in a slow motion. In dreams, if you want to punch somebody, though you are moving your hand very fast, you can't punch him with full power. The next question is whether a blind person who is blind since his childhood, can he get some dreams? Absolutely not. He will not get any dreams like us. There are two reasons. The first one is he will not have any color differentiation. The second one is he will not know any shapes. Because of these two main reasons, he will not get any dreams. Whereas he may get dreams based on sounds. He will get only dreams made of sounds. The last question is whether animals get dreams or not. Yes, animals get the dreams. Not all the animals, all the mammals and birds, they get dreams. It is scientifically proved. Rest of the animals won't get any dreams. In the upcoming video, we will be seeing how to get a better sleep. What are the foods we have to take? What are the foods you should avoid it? I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks for watching.
Comment this video, subscribe our channel to get our updates.